Anyway, next question. Do you ever fake enjoyment during intimacy?
Fake enjoyment.
Yep, like fake moaning.
Yeah, I have ever faked.
How many times did you?
Just once. Or thrice or something.
Sama tu kweli. After this video, we are not going to talk about this. So sita kugombanisha. Sama tu kweli. If you fake, just tell me you fake.
Unajua, sometimes unaweza ona mtu maybe yeah, anaenjoy na maybe we feel kitu.
Okay.
Unaelewa. So, maybe see it.
Hi guys, welcome back or welcome back to our YouTube channel. Okay, that introduction is so cliche. But anyway, guys, welcome back. Thank you so much for stopping by. Today we have an amazing video. And on top of that, we have a guest. Mwana Mpotev, where have you been?
Mimi nigi.
We think of tumekuwa na vlogs mingi, but you have not been so much into those vlogs.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, nimekuwa tu.
Anyway,
in the background, I was directing.
Okay, so anyway, guys, I'm so delighted to be here today, guys, for another video. Although last video, you guys, kunipatia yani real views, some real support. I think you guys suggested for me vlogs, but probably you guys don't like vlogs, or rather, you did not vibe with my vlog. But anyway, guys, there's no problem. All the suggestions and yes, mmekuwa mkinipatia, I'll actually do videos. Na mjue tuko naendelea ku perfect vitu. So see ati you expect nikuwe perfect all at once. So if I see guys that you don't like that, I'll try another thing that you guys like. Anyway, too much talking. So today, as you've read the title, we have a very interesting video. And the person seated here has no idea of the questions that I'm going to ask him. I'm going to ask him questions that guys are usually so uncomfortable.
Wait. Really?
Yes. Actually, so, this is not among my questions. Among my questions. It's not even in the list of my questions. But tell me, do you guys enjoy being spanked?
Man. No.
Why are you always so defensive
in
when I spank you?
Letters. That is not a thing for us. Like, you can't spank a man.
Bona.
That is gay.
Okay.
But anyway, that is, it is so uncomfortable. Mm. Like, I don't know how I can describe it. It is just against being a man.
Wow. Yeah. It's against being a man.
Yeah.
Anyway, guys.
So first of all, what are you spanking? We have no meat back there. We have, okay, it's not, yeah, there's, you know, that's why, I don't have a concrete way of saying why, because it is so wrong.
Anyway, guys, it is
a taboo.
Okay, fine. let's go back to our list. So I have a list of about 15 to 20 questions that you are going to answer intensively. And the first question is, what do you honestly think about girls making the first move?
First of all, they are courageous to do such a thing.
Mm.
But anyway, maybe cheap.
Cheap, really?
Yeah,
if
why?
Girls make the first move, they are cheap. Who is cheap now? The men girls?
I think when a girl does the first move, I think they, first of all, like I said, they are courageous.
Okay.
Yeah, and they really feel you.
Mm.
So, yeah.
Anyway, Second question is, do you ever compare your partner to your exes?
Me.
You're talking about you.
Okay.
Even though these are general questions that I'm supposed to like ask all the men, but I only have one man here, you. So now give us your point of view on the questions that I'm asking you. Now, do you ever compare your partner to your exes?
No, and sometimes yes, on specific things.
Okay, like?
Like compare, you know, compare like how in terms of beauty am I?
Comparing like, in everything. Of, huh? Yes, you have said sometimes no, sometimes yes. So no, we are done. Now yes, what do you compare?
These questions are getting me off guard. But I really don't compare in the sense of beauty and all that, because you are beautiful than them. The only thing that I can say, maybe some things that I don't know.
You're not clear on the question, but anyway, to save maybe time, just
pass that question, because I don't have anything that I
any know. Next question, do you prefer being dominant or submissive in the matters of BD?
No, yeah, dominance, of course, that is my pride.
You like being dominant, of not submissive, I mean.
How, that is changing of roles.
So the woman is supposed to be submissive and you the dominant.
Mm-hmm.
Well, anyway, next question. Do you ever fake enjoyment during intimacy?
Fake enjoyment.
Yep, like fake morning.
Yeah, I have ever faked.
How many times did you?
Just once, or twice or something.
Sama tu kweli. After this video, we are not going to talk about this. Or sita kugombanisha. Sama tu kweli. If you fake, just tell me you fake.
Unajua, sometimes unaweza ona mtu maybe yeah, ana enjoy na maybe u feel kitu.
Okay.
Unaelewa. So, maybe see it you feel, but then unapata, you know.
Do you know what?
The stingos.
You're not feeling the stingos.
Yeah, then maybe the stingo is not for you. But then because it is
because they prefer it, now you fake enjoying the stingo.
Or they are feeling it.
What? Next question. How do you feel about women initiating sex more often? How do you feel about women initiating?
Initiating?
Yep.
Maybe they are in that time of the month when the curve is on the optimum. So I don't think whether I feel anything, just that maybe it might be awkward.
So you feel awkward when now personally me when I initiated.
Oftenly, it is not a problem, but when it happens oftenly, I'm like, might run.
Okay, next question. What is your honest opinion on women being more successful than men?
They have been empowered so much.
Okay, women so, empowerment. So now what is your opinion on like women being more successful than men?
That's good. Of course, like if they are successful, you know, some of them are I've worked towards their success.
Okay.
So they deserve it. Mm. Unless a person is not doing it out of their dignity.
Okay.
Yeah, so it's okay with me for successful women to be at the top.
Oh wow, mm-hmm. That is nice. Mm. Okay, next question.
Are those awkward questions?
No, actually I'm trying to filter.
Why are you filtering?
Hey. Okay. What is the sex? Okay, nimevuka kwanza. Does size really matter to men? That was the question I was looking for. Does size really matter to men?
Of course.
Okay.
Of course.
So you feel more confident with a bigger cucumber, yeah, than a small one?
Of course. It gives you... It's not like it matters. But then it gives you that confidence. How can you have a small thing? Like,
so it's does like it for really
women.
Not,
it's like for women. Let me ask that question for you.
Okay.
How do you feel without with a small behind? Like a very small one.
So a small behind.
No, I've not asked. I'm like, not how you feel. Does it matter?
To me, it doesn't matter. Maybe to have someone nothing. Else.
Having a flat base.
To me, it doesn't really matter. The work of that thing is to sit down. So as long as it's serving the purpose, that's it.
That is life. So on the other end, the other one is also life.
Hmm. Aya. Hey, where are these questions? Yo. Do you feel pressured to always perform well during XX?
To perform well?
Yes. Do you like normally feel the pressure that, okay, like when you start the act, like you're supposed to perform well?
That is like an exam. You have to perform. So it's, you have, like, it gives you a good track record.
Okay.
Actually, if you don't perform well, it can lower your dignity.
Okay.
But then, I think there are those good times, mm-hmm, when the performance is good. There are those times when the performance is low. So, yeah, and it is like everything, like it is basically like life. There are those high moments, there are those low moments, but of course, you have to perform.
Okay, how much do you really care about your physical appearance?
So much. It is the picture that I display out there. So it has to be good.
Mm.
It has to look good.
Mm.
Mm. Physical appearance.
So how much do you really care about it? So much?
So much, actually.
Mm.
Very much.
Well, what is your biggest fear in a marriage?
My biggest fear?
Yep.
Till death do us apart.
That is your biggest fear in marriage? Till death do you part?
Mm.
So, like, expound. I don't understand you. Like, expound on that.
When you don't have your partner there with you.
Oh, you mean like when they are dead?
Yeah.
Okay.
Isn't that a fear, of course? Don't you fear for you? Like, ugogopangi?
Of course, naogopa. But it has never hit me. That I'll be here like without you. Like I'll be like living like alone and you're not there, and you're not there because of death. Like it has never hit me. It's something that has never, like, it doesn't cross my mind that much. So to me, I can't classify it as my fear. But to you, it's a fear. So now I understand your point of view. What do you think about marriage?
Marriage is a good thing. It is. It gives you that self actualization, identity, and all that. And it is a step in life where you're growing and exploring so much in marriage. So it's really a good thing. Like, I find it to be a stage in life where you're becoming a better self. But on the other hand, you can just become, it can also break you if you don't have the right partner, probably.
Okay.
Yeah, but then marriage is such a good thing. I can say that. There are lots of things that come with it.
Okay. So, next question. Why do some men, some, avoid talking about their emotions? Actually, do you even use the word some, or even actually most of men?
You see,
avoid talking about their emotions.
Yeah, because now that is being a man, you don't have to like always show emotions on everything.
Whoa.
Yeah. It's not like you can't show emotions, but I'm saying in the sense like you can't have like usually tell you I can't be reacting to everything. A small thing.
You have not understood my emotions. Question.
Oh, okay.
Why do some men avoid talking about their emotions?
Avoid talking about their emotions. I think as a man, you can figure read. You have that nature. It is like a natural behavior where you can create or you can recreate. So I think talking about it, it's not a big deal. You can handle it. Just being a man.
It is very ambiguous. Okay. To me, I think, although I'm not even supposed to answer this, there's some thread I was following in Twitter, and they were talking about why actually men don't express their emotions. And they were saying the reason why men don't actually express their emotions is because they feel like showing your emotions inakufanya ukae a weak person.
Of course. Yeah, that is, I can relate to that. Like,
but that is wrong. Showing your emotions doesn't mean you're weak.
But you know that it comes out naturally because it's
Remember, not all.
Yeah. I'm saying, like, not everyone, but showing your emotions, you feel weak from inside.
Wow, okay.
So showing that, it degrades you or something.
Wow. Okay. So like showing your emotions degrades you. That is how you feel about it.
So it's so hard to explain because it's something that you feel from inside. Like you don't have to show emotion because you can figure something out.
I think you're not understanding my questions. But anyway, let's just move on.
Let's pass that one.
What is one thing that can make you lose interest in someone quickly? Like, what is your turn off?
Someone who doesn't respect people.
Okay, on to our almost last question. What's something that you've always wanted to try sexually but you haven't yet?
That I've always wanted to
try sexually but you haven't yet.
I don't know. Not sure of any that I can think right now. Maybe that question has gotten me off guard. I don't know. Currently, I don't know something that I haven't tried and I would want to try.
Anyway, our last question, guys. How often do you think about XX in a day?
Every time. Okay, several. Of course.
Okay.
Even now.
No, don't go there. Anyway, guys, those are the questions that I had for him. I think we'll have a part two. He was not actually prepared.
Yeah, and some of those questions are very deep in terms of...
We like deep questions because we like answers that, yani elaborative, yani, you elaborate and answer well.
Okay, next time you'll prepare me so that I can...
Yes, next time I'll prepare you and in advance so that... Ningekuja kukuuliza maswali, ukuwe na an idea of what we are going to be talking about. But anyway, guys, thank you so much for having us. Thank you so much for watching. If you have really watched up to this end, up to this point, I really appreciate you so much. And also, guys, thank you so very much. We are at 700 subscribers.
700+.
Yes, 700+ subscribers. I'm really not sure about the figures right now.
Bracket of 700 to 800.
Yeah, in between there. So it's easy to say 700 plus subscribers because the other day we were celebrating 700 subscribers. So anyway, guys, keep on subscribing. We are on our road to 1,000 as I promised that I'm going to be consistent, guys. Munaona, at least I'm consistent, yeah? Yeah? So guys, keep appreciating me by just subscribing, commenting on my videos. Actually, guys, I really love your comments. And especially those long comments that either you agree or disagree with something that I've said. I like them. So, guys, stay positive and attract
good vibration. Positive, right?
Always stay positive.
And attract good vibration.
Yes. So, for now, we are going to close up the video and shout out to actually all of you. Do you have a special shout out?
Yeah, shout out to a camera person.
Hey, who director to Gani bana? Okay, bye bye guys. Until next time.